Hello everyone. So today I am going to talk about the equilibrium constant, and it's a very important concept for chemical reaction engineering. So what is equilibrium constant? So the equilibrium constant of a chemical reaction is the value of its reaction quotient at chemical equilibrium. Now, so what is chemical quotient? Chemical quotient means, in chemical thermodynamic, the chemical quotient is a quantity that provides a measurement of the relative quantities of products and reactants which are present in any chemical reaction or in chemical reaction mixture with well-defined overall stoichiometry at a particular point of time. Mathematically, we can say it is defined as the ratio of sometimes we use as a molar concentration of the product components or product species over the reactant species, and taking stoichiometric coefficients of the reaction into account as exponents of the concentration. Now let's discuss for a system undergoing a reversible reaction, which is described by any chemical reaction. So let's take, we have AA plus BB. So small letters define the stoichiometry of these reactants, and capital letters are the reactants. And CC plus DD. Okay, so these are the products and these are the reactants. Okay, so a thermodynamic equilibrium constant is denoted by K, and it is defined as the value of the reaction quotient. Okay, so when forward and reverse reaction occur at the same rate. Okay, so at chemical equilibrium, the chemical composition of the mixture does not change with time, and the Gibbs free energy change. So change in Gibbs free energy is equal to, for that particular reaction will be equal to the zero. If the composition of a mixture at equilibrium is changed, then if there is some addition of any reagent, a new equilibrium position will be reached. Okay, so every time whenever we add some reactants, right, so we achieve or we reach to a new equilibrium state. Okay, so K and Ka for this, let's take, this is the equation one. So for the reaction one is defined in terms of activity of reactants and product. So K, which is equilibrium constant, or Ka for the activity. Okay. So here what we have, ratio of product over reactant, right? Product over reactant. So how we can write this? See. So here we have, this is A. This is the activity, okay, in terms of activity. So products, so capital C, and this is stoichiometric coefficient is at as an exponent, fine. Then activity, capital D, small d, divided by activity of this, and BB, okay. And A is what? Activity of pure component, AI, right? Activity of pure component, which we know that. Activity of pure component I. Fine. So how we can write this when it is in the ratio? So summation of AI and stoichiometric coefficient, how we can define AI, nu I. Let's take, this is the equation number 2. So we know that AI is the activity of component I, and nu I stoichiometric coefficient of, this is what? Stoichiometric coefficient of component I. So Now, we know that activity is the ratio of fugacity, partial fugacity into the partial fugacity of component I over fugacity at standard state. So, this is the fugacity of component. Partial means we know that fugacity of component I in mixture, and this is the fugacity of component I at standard state. Fine. So, how we can write this? K is equals to Ka summation of Fi over Fi naught exponent of stoichiometric coefficient, and this is now defined by new term which is called Kf, right? So this is equilibrium constant in terms of fugacity. We have Kf summation of Fi bar upon Fi naught nu I, fine. At a standard state, fugacity of any pure component is equals to 1. So Fi naught is equals to 1. Fine. Therefore, Kf is become summation of Fi bar nu I. Fine. Let's take this as the equation number 4, where Kf is equilibrium constant in terms of fugacity of component. Fine. And for liquid and solid, the equilibrium constants are not numerically equal as a standard state because fugacity are not unit at that time. Okay. Now, another equilibrium constant which is frequently used in the study of gaseous reaction is Kp. So, here we can just write down in terms of partial pressure. So, Pi bar mu I. Let's take this as the equation number 5. Okay. So, now using the relation fugacity coefficient phi I bar is equals to Fi bar upon Pi bar, which is the partial fugacity of component I, and this is the partial pressure of component I. So rearrange this, therefore we get Fi bar is equals to phi I bar Pi bar. Let's take this as the equation number 6. Fine. So now from equation number 4 and 6, from equation 4 and 6, Kf is equals to, in place of Fi, what we put, we substitute phi I bar Pi bar nu I, okay, and this will equal to phi I bar nu I Pi bar nu I. Okay. This is what? This is the fugacity equilibrium constant at in terms of what? In terms of fugacity coefficient, and this is what? Kp in terms of pressure. Okay. So Kf is equals to Kf is equals to K phi Kp. So this relation is applicable for gaseous system. If gas behaves ideally, then phi I bar is equals to Fi bar upon Pi bar is equals to 1, right? So then K is equals to Kf is equals to Kp, and this term will be equal to 1, okay? So this is a another relation. This is also a one relation. So these are the some relations for equilibrium constant. Equilibrium constant, there are different many types of equilibrium constant, and we can write equilibrium constant in different terms. Jaisa bhi term aap use kar rahe hoge, jis term mein bhi aap reaction koi data given hoga, you can write in that term. Okay. So the numerical value of equilibrium constant depend on, most important thing is on form of stoichiometric equation. Right, the numerical value of equilibrium constant depend on form of stoichiometric equation. Okay, so this is all about the equilibrium constant. In our next video, we will discuss the equilibrium constant and standard free energy change. Hopefully, we will be able to understand this.